Direct injection engines essentially have two different modes, homogeneous mode and stratified charge mode. The same goes for the M272DE. This chapter looks at the differences between homogeneous and stratified charge modes and some of the special features of the combustion process and air ducting. But why have two different operating modes anyway? It's all a question of priority, and to this question, there is a clear answer. In homogeneous mode, the priority is high torque and high power output. By contrast, in stratified charge mode, the priority is to minimize fuel consumption. The engine control unit switches between these two operating modes according to requirements, without impairing driving performance. The switching is map controlled, using a number of parameters. Playing an important role here, alongside such parameters as engine load and engine speed, is the operating status of the nitrogen oxide catalysts. In general, we can say that the engine runs in homogeneous mode when idling and at full load. In the part load range, however, it operates primarily in stratified charge mode to reduce fuel consumption. Here, the most crucial limiting factor to be taken into account is the status of the NOx catalysts. Here's a brief overview of the main functional differences between homogeneous operation and stratified charge operation. By the way, a more detailed analysis of these differences can be found in the study program Direct Injection Petrol Engines. In homogeneous mode, the engine is operated approximately at lambda equals 1. The mixture ratio is uniform throughout the entire combustion chamber. The mixture cloud is therefore homogeneous. By contrast, in stratified charge mode, the mixture ratios in the injection spray cone range from lambda equals 1 to an extremely lean lambda equals 3. The mixture cloud is therefore non-homogeneous or stratified, hence the name of this operating mode. Ignitability is ensured by targeted injection at the spark plug's overhead electrode. The result is an average lambda value of between 1.3 and 2.5 for the combustion chamber as a whole. In homogeneous mode, internal exhaust gas recirculation by means of valve overlap is sufficient. External recirculation is deactivated. In stratified charge mode, both internal and external exhaust gas recirculation are deployed. The recirculation rate can be as much as 30%. In homogeneous mode, injection takes place during the intake stroke, as is usual in petrol engines. In stratified charge mode, however, injection takes place during the compression stroke instead. Homogeneous mode and stratified charge mode differ greatly when it comes to exhaust gas treatment. In homogeneous mode, the oxides of nitrogen are converted, along with the other pollutants, in the three-way catalysts, as normal. In stratified charge mode, it is not possible to catalyze the oxides of nitrogen because of the very lean mixture. The three-way catalysts are ineffective here. As a result, the unconverted oxides of nitrogen are first stored in special NOx storage catalysts. However, these stores only have limited absorption capacity. They have to be continually regenerated. To regenerate them, the engine is switched briefly to homogeneous mode. Once the lambda value is less than 1, the stored oxides of nitrogen can be converted as normal. Let's now have a closer look at stratified charge mode. This operating mode uses a completely new type of combustion process, known as the spray-guided combustion process. Here, the shape of the spray is determined purely by the injection nozzle. Specially developed piezo injectors are used as the injection nozzles. The spray-guided combustion process is necessary for stratified charge mode, but also ensures excellent combustion in homogeneous mode. The mixture cloud created by the spray has a hollow cone shape and is located in the center of the combustion chamber. The mixture composition in the cone-shaped cloud is stratified. The lambda value varies between around 1 at the cone wall and around 3 in the center of the cone. The mixture, therefore, gets leaner towards the center of the cone. Outside the conical cloud is a layer of air that is virtually free of fuel. In other words, the lambda value outside the spray cone is very high, virtually infinite. Strictly speaking, this is an air exhaust gas mixture, since external exhaust gas recirculation is activated in stratified charge mode. This air exhaust gas layer insulates the flame from the cylinder wall, thereby stabilizing the combustion temperature. The average lambda value for the combustion chamber as a whole is between 1.3 and 2.5. A lean mixture like this ensures complete combustion. This reduces fuel consumption and consequently pollutant emissions substantially. Maximum ignitability is ensured by the fact that the wall of the conical cloud, where lambda is around 1, lies directly in the path of the spark from the spark plug. With the spray-guided combustion process, therefore, it is important that the spark plug is positioned exactly. The overhead electrode must have a precisely defined position with respect to the conical spray. If the spark plug is slightly too high, the path of the spark will be outside the spray cone. The ignition spark will not come into contact with the mixture at all. If the spark plug is too low, it will protrude into the lean layers of the spray cone. Likewise, here too, there is no guarantee that ignition will occur. As a result, it is particularly vital that the tightening torque for the spark plugs of the DE engine is adhered to exactly. Depending on load, there are either 2 or 3 injection processes per ignition process in stratified charge mode. Pilot injection and main injection occur before ignition. The optional post-injection process occurs, if at all, after ignition. The previously mentioned piezo injectors are required in order to achieve these very short injection intervals. In stratified charge mode, the engine is essentially de-throttled. The injection quantity is therefore no longer determined by the mass of air being supplied. This ensures maximum supply of intake air under all operating conditions. External exhaust gas recirculation is also enabled in stratified charge mode. Feeding in exhaust gas with a low oxygen content lowers the combustion peak temperature, and consequently also reduces the formation of nitrogen oxides. This means that the intervals between storage catalyst regeneration phases, the phases which require a switch to homogeneous mode, increase. Or, expressed another way, the duration of uninterrupted stratified charge mode is increased. In the air ducting system of the DE engine, there are 2 particular features which distinguish it from that of the KE variant. Firstly, there are no tumble flaps. Secondly, the throttle valve actuator is only used in homogeneous mode to regulate intake air. In stratified charge mode, it is always fully open. The engine is therefore de-throttled. As you have already seen, external exhaust gas recirculation is activated in stratified charge mode. For this, the DE engine requires some special components. The exhaust gas is removed from behind the 2 3-way catalysts. It is first conveyed towards the intake pipe in 2 separate lines. The recirculation rate can be steplessly regulated. Specifically, up to 30% of the intake air quantity can be made up of exhaust gas. The ME control unit regulates the recirculation rate in accordance with a map and as a function of engine load. Each of the two recirculation lines has a continuously variable valve with actuator motor. The valves and motors are combined into one single compact component. Behind the recirculation valves, the exhaust gases are combined into one single connecting pipe and conveyed into the intake pipe. And as you already know, both the actuator motors and the connecting pipe are liquid cooled. As you saw earlier, the spark plug on the DE engine, unlike on the KE engine, is not positioned centrally above the cylinder. It is now located on the exhaust side. This also means that the ignition coil has had to move. Instead of being connected directly to the spark plug, it is positioned above it and connected to it by means of a cable.